Friends, welcome back to my channel. After much requesting, I finally was able to sit down and show you how to do my imPress nails. I definitely recommend these. Can't wait for you to try them out. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. But aside from that, brace yourselves. You're about to see my really not so nice naked nails up close. So let's go ahead and get started with the tutorial. Okay, so please excuse my nasty naked nails. It's like being on camera without makeup. They are in very rough shape, which is why I'm always wearing imPress nails. I'm gonna go through the three things that you need to have that I always use when I am using imPress nails. First thing that I have is the Kiss Brush-On Nail Glue. This stuff is basically how I apply. Just like it shows you here, this stuff is basically like putting on nail polish. It's the most user-friendly nail glue that I've ever used, and I have bottles upon bottles of this. I bought a new one just so I could show you guys what the packaging and everything looks like. It is a little bit pricier than getting the regular nail glue, but it's worth the extra like dollar because it just makes it so easy to apply. And then the other nail glue that I always have on hand is the Precision Nail Glue. I like this because, as you can see in the picture here, it has a really precise point. With my nails, I don't have like super warped nails. I have pretty like average shaped nail beds and things like that. But sometimes the like corners or the like outer part of the nails can start to lift. And so what I use this for is I'll take that little tip and I'll basically like pinch up the nail and I'll lift in and place some glue there and press it back down. And that just further seals everything after I've been wearing the nails for a few days. So I always recommend having these personally. I keep one of each of these in my purse on top of keeping them at home. So I always have two in my like repertoire overall, just because you never know like when a nail might accidentally pop off. It doesn't happen to me very often, but when it does, it's a wicked pain in the butt. And so if I always have these glues with me, then it never is a problem. And then I obviously swear by the imPress nails. You guys see me in like tons of empties wearing these. I like these because these have the hold on the back of them, and I couple it up with the adhesive. Technically, you don't need to use the adhesive glue because these have adhesive on the back of them. But for me to get like the full week and a half's wear, these two combined together make them amazing. But if you're only looking to wear nails like a couple of days or for one night, then you could just use the adhesive on the back. I also like the length of these. Personally, I don't do any trimming or shortening or anything like that to my nails. I literally just put these on my nails, but I do have a girlfriend who wears these and she has like filed these down or clipped them and then filed them down to better meet her like nail length needs. But for me, I like these because they're nice and short. I've tried the Kiss nails before, which is the sister company of imPress, and those don't have the same wearability for me as these do, so I will always go with the Kiss nails. So let's go ahead and start by opening everything. So give me one second. Okay, so this is what everything looks like when it's all set out. Inside the package, it comes with the prep pad, it comes with a little tiny nail file, and it comes with like a cuticle presser. I typically don't use any of these things. I do like to use, I'll use the pad today, but normally I prefer to use just acetone and wipe it on my nails. I know it's not the healthiest thing for your nails, but I like to do it because it removes any oils that are typically like naturally on my nails. And by removing the oils, I tend to get a better adhesive stick between the nail and my natural nails. I'll also admit my nails are a lot shorter than they have been in the past like couple of months. I've just been really bad about picking them when I do take my imPress nails off and I've been really stressed. So typically my nails being this short is not ideal because there's not as much surface area for the imPress nail to stick to. It is better when your nails are a little bit longer, but I'm just gonna roll with it anyways because I can't stand my nails looking this atrocious on the regular. So what I do first and what they recommend is they recommend that you move from pinky to thumb. And so the reason why they do that is because if you notice on the actual nail, You'll see here that there's that plastic tab. It's easiest to rip them off with your thumbs, but as you are going, if you do your thumbs first, it makes it harder to rip off that little plastic tab to then be able to get to the nail side. So what I do first is I typically match up all the nails I want and I lay them out pinky to thumb, and then I go through and I will place them on my nails. We've talked in the past about the fact that I get two sets out of these. Basically what that means is with like these nails, a lot of them, because I have really average shaped nails, a lot of them are, you know, pretty close to matching my nails. So like even for example, the two pinky type nails. So I technically can get away with wearing either or of these. So typically I'll wear this on my first set and then I'll wear this type of nail the second go around with them, which is why I feel like you get a lot of bang for your buck. The other thing is with the accent nails, you can choose to follow whatever pattern you would like, but typically I follow what they put on the picture. They don't always match up the box of nails with the actual icon picture on there, but when they do, I typically follow it. You can also always like hashtag imPress nail search on Instagram and you can find other inspiration ideas as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and match these up. Some things you can do that make it somewhat user-friendly is on each of the nails, I don't know if it's gonna zoom in for you. On each of the nails, you can see that there is a number. Sometimes, more often than not, I will find a nail that I like that will fit on my pinky, and then I'll just look for the same nail that's the number. Typically, they'll work out for both of my nails if you have fingernails that are pretty even on both hands. I'm gonna go ahead and do that. So what I'll do is I'll find a nail that I think might be a good fit. I'll lay it on there. I like what I see. You don't have to stress too much about it because if there's a little bit left on like the sides or something, no one's going to notice that, you know, up close when looking at your nails. They'll just see the actual nail sitting there. So I like the way that looks. I'm going to look for a similar nail, which looks to be this one. So I'm going to put it on my pinky to see if I like it. Looks like it fits. So I'm just gonna go ahead and put these over to the side, knowing that these are my pinky nails, and now I'll move into my ring fingers. Okay, so now that I have the nails pinky to thumb laid out, what I do is I go back, because again, I will be able to wear these again, and I place a couple of the colors back into this box just so I know quickly looking what they actually are, and then the rest I stick back inside the compartment. Put the cover over it. And then I stick it back in the box. You may not be able to get uses out of these. I know my sister, for example, has much wider nail beds than I do. And so she actually will get a set out and then she gives me the boxes just in case I can get a full set out of them and use them. So I just tuck these back into my shoebox that I have with all of my options in here. Some people also, I know like my girlfriend who only gets one wear out of these as well, she also keeps these in her purse with her. That way she's able to, if case one nail falls off and she can't like find it randomly, she does have these available to pop them back on. But to each their own. I don't carry nails on me just because I find that by carrying glue, I'm typically pretty set. I've never had an experience where I've lost a nail and can't find it. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and pop these on. As I mentioned, what I'll do is I will typically peel off the backing, which is really easy to do. The hardest part is that it sticks to your fingers. I'll peel both of the pinkies off first and I lay them upside down just so I'm ready to pull them. And then I will pop open the glue. And just like nail polish, I lay glue down on my nail bed. put it back in, and then I grab my nail. It's not like it will dry relatively quickly, but you have time. There's no need to panic. So then I place it on. I make sure I place it on nice and straight, and then I hold it down. The instructions technically tell you not to push down, but I find that it adheres better when I push down on the, you know, different angles of my nail to get everything to stay down. And we have a one nail ready to go. I'm gonna go ahead and do my other pinky. This is also pretty foolproof in the sense that if you like miss your nail, the glue isn't really noticeable and it will wash off. Typically in the shower, any like excess glue I have washes off. I've literally done these anywhere. I've taken them on the train in Boston and done my nails on the T. I've done them in the car. I've done them at school. Like one time I went out before conferences and my nails were atrocious looking. So I just went out, popped on into CVS and then came back and like within 10 minutes was able to put these on. They don't take too long. I mean, I basically know at this point, like my thumbs, I typically always use a number 2 or a number 3 on my thumbs. So I know the numbers pretty well that work for my nails since I've been wearing them for so long. Occasionally you'll get a weird box where they don't actually have 2 of the same number, but again, they're pretty close enough that you wouldn't necessarily be too distraught if you had a 6 and a 7 being placed on your ring fingers, for example. But I just really love these because when I do paint my nails, I constantly get chips and it's really a pain in the butt to be constantly painting my nails, or like I'll constantly paint them and like I don't wait long enough even when I use nail polish dryer, and so I'll smudge them. Like it's never a perfect science for me with fingernail polish, and these are pretty foolproof aside from my nails being stupidly short because I am atrocious and can't have nice things. My nails aren't ruined from this. Like they're not brittle any more than usual when I would be painting my nails. They're not scuffed up or anything like that because the glue really just pops off. Like typically what I'll do is I'll buff my nail down and that will get all of the remaining glue off of them. But typically when I take these off, it's because they're already naturally starting to pop off. And so that's when I typically will give them up, or it's after like when the nails are starting to get misshapen and worn down, that's when they're ready to come off naturally anyways. My sister is a PA and she washes her hands constantly because she works at a hospital, and these will last for her a little bit less than they will for me. Not that I don't wash my hands, but I'm just not doing it every like 30 minutes the way she does, but she wears these and, you know, she wears gloves all the time and they're able to, you know, withstand all of that. So I would say these are definitely worth it. The other thing to keep in mind is it does show you on the back of the box that you are supposed to put these on a certain way. If you ever get confused after you take the sticky part off, because that's a really easy way to understand how to put them on, if you just notice on the back of the nail, if I can get the right lighting, there's a little bit of a section at the very top where there is no sticky adhesive. That is where, theoretically, it's supposed to hang past your natural nail. For me, as you can see, it is definitely more than that section. But that's another way to know how to stick these on, is wherever you see that there's no longer adhesive at the very tip, that is the part that is supposed to be at the top part of your nail. The only complaint that I sometimes have with imPress nails, and this is very small and nitpicky, most people probably won't matter to, but if you look at like this thumb, for example, you'll maybe be able to see there's a little bit of like a plastic section in the very middle that looks like they broke it off of some kind of like original mold or something. I sometimes will file this down so it's completely even. It doesn't happen on all of the nails, but typically it's thumbs that will show that little tiny like extra piece. Maybe you can't even tell what I'm talking about, but really and truly, that is as simple as it gets. I've officially got my nails on. They are durable. They're not going anywhere. They're not moving around. They are officially on here. Like I mentioned at the very start with the precision glue, I'll occasionally use this because sometimes on like the curve parts or on the outer parts, they start to maybe pop up, and that's when I'll be able to take the precision tip, squeeze some down in there, and then press it back down, because the middle part of your nails where it has the biggest grip onto your natural nail, and so they tend to sit really well on there. But I hope you guys have enjoyed this. I'm sorry it took me so long to be able to show this to you. If you have any questions about imPress nails, let me know in the comments below. I'll also link their website down below where you can get imPress nails. They sell them on Amazon too, but they don't sell them for a very consistent price, so I recommend the imPress site. They have really fair prices on there, and they have pretty reasonable shipping. You guys know I love these, wear them all the time. But that's it for me. I'll talk to you in my next video real soon. Bye.